Hello everyone! Kumusta? In this video, we will be discussing about fractions, decimals, and percent. Let's start with fractions. We have three different fractions or types of fractions, one of which is proper fraction. A proper fraction is a number representing a part of a whole. This whole may be a single object or groups of object or a group of objects. For example, we have 1/2, 3/4, 5/8, 7/11, 24/25. Now, these examples are proper fractions. We have here improper fractions. Improper fraction is a number in which the numerator is greater than the denominator. Or yung numero sa taas ng fraction ay mas malaki compared sa numero sa iba sa baba ng fractions. For example, 3/2, 4/3, 9/5, 13/6, and 25/4. Again, pag mas malaki ang number sa taas ng fraction or ng numerator, meaning ito ay improper fraction. Kapag mas malaki ang numero ng numerator compared sa denominator, it is what? An improper fraction. And last, we have a mixed fraction. Mixed fraction is a combination of a natural number and a proper fraction. Again, natural number and a proper fraction. For example, 1/1, 4/2, 12/3/15, 3/4/9, 5/7/8. Again, combination siya ng whole number and then proper fractions. Let's proceed to adding and subtracting of fraction. But before we go there, we have to know first na mayroong dalawang klaseng fraction in terms of formation niya or kapag ina-add or sinasubtract. First, we have similar fractions. Similar fractions are just fractions that have the same denominator. Again, kung meron tayong i-add or i-subtract na dalawang fractions and then same ang kanilang denominator, that means they are similar fractions. For example, we have 3/5 and 1/5. Same sila ng denominator. That means they are similar fraction. Same as 3/7 and 2/7. Again, same sila ng denominator. Now, kung iba naman ang denominator or magkaiba ang denominator ng dalawang fraction, they are considered as dissimilar fractions. And dissimilar fractions are two or more fractions are codissimilar or unlike fractions if they have different denominators. Example, we have 4/5 and 3/8. Magkaiba ang kanilang mga denominator. That's why they are considered to be dissimilar fraction. 7/11 and 4/10. Again, magkaiba ang denominator. Therefore, they are dissimilar fraction. So, how do we add or subtract similar fractions? We just copy the denominator, then perform the indicated operation, whether it is addition or subtraction. For example, 3/5 minus 1/5. So, we are just going to copy yung denominator and then perform kung ano ang operation na indicated. That is 3 minus 1. Yung atin lang i-operate ay yung numerator lang. Okay? That is 3 minus 1 is 2. That's why the answer of 3/5 minus 1/5 is 2/5. Another example, we have here 3/7 plus 2/7. Again, copy lang yung denominator and then i-plus natin yung numerator, that is 3 plus 2, that is 5/7. How about if you're going to add or subtract these similar fractions? to add or subtract dissimilar fractions or unlike fractions, change the similar fraction into similar fraction or like fraction, then add or subtract the fraction as similar fraction. The sum or difference must be in the lowest term. So, kung mag-a-add tayo ng dissimilar fraction, first na kailangan natin gawin ay i-change yung dissimilar fractions into similar fractions. And then, we're free to perform the operation. For example, 4 over 5 plus 3 over 8. Magkaiba ang kanilang mga denominator. So, they are dissimilar fractions. So, how do we solve this? We're going to solve this by finding the LCD or the least common denominator by, we can use the listing method. So, we're going to list down the multiples of each denominator. So, the multiples of 5 are 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, and so on. While the multiples of 8 are 8, 16, 24, 32, 40, and so on. So, their common multiple is 40. So, we're going to use this as their common denominator. So, we're going to convert the fractions into similar fraction. The dissimilar to similar. So, 40 divided by 5 is 8 times 4 is 32. So, from 4 over 5, naging 32 over 40 siya. Equal pa rin yan. Wala tayong violate na rules in equality. So, let's transform the 3 over 8. 40 divided by 8 is 5, and 5 times 3 is 15. So now, meron na tayong similar fractions. Meron na tayong 32 over 40 and 15 over 40. Now, we can perform the indicated operation, which is addition. So, meron tayong copy the denominator, 32 plus 15, the answer is 47 over 40. As you can see, yung answer natin ay hindi siya naka-proper fraction o hindi siya naka-mixed number. Improper fraction siya. We have to convert this to a mixed fraction para maging lowest term yung sagot natin. So, how do we do it? We just divide the numerator by the denominator. So, that is 47 divided by 40. Ilang bang 40 mayroon sa 47? Isa lang. And 1 times 40 is 40. Then, we subtract it. 47 minus 40 is 7. Now, yung 1 dyan, or yung numero sa taas, yan ang magiging whole number natin. And then, yung remainder ay yung magiging numerator, and then, yung divisor natin, yung 40, ang magiging denominator. So, we have here 1 and 7 over 40. Now, this is the answer. It is in its lowest term and final term. Next, we're going to subtract this similar fraction. Same lang nung ginawa natin kanina, we're just going to find the multiples of each denominator so that we can find the least common denominator. So, the multiples of 2 are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and 12. The multiples of 5 are 5, 10, 15, and 20. Their LCM is 10. So, we will going to use 10 as the denominator of these two fraction. Then, same lang ginawa natin kanina, we have 10 divided by 2 times 1. 10 divided by 2 is 5, times 1 is 5. And then, 10 divided by 5 is 2, times 2 is 4. Now, we can subtract these fractions because they are similar fractions already. So, copy natin yung 10, and then 5 minus 4 is 1. So, 1 over 10. Now, 1 over 10, is it the final answer? Yes, it is the final answer because it is the lowest term already. How about if we're going to add mixed numbers? Well, to add mixed numbers, kailangan muna natin siyang i-transform into improper fractions. So, from mixed number, kailangan siyang maging improper fractions. So, here, we have here, to change it or to transform it to an improper fraction, just copy the denominator, which is 2. And then, we're going to multiply the denominator to the whole number. So, that is 2 times 2. And then, yung sagot nila ay i-add natin sa numerator. 2 times 2 is 4 plus 1 is 5. Let's do the same sa isa pang fraction. Copy the denominator, multiply the denominator and to the whole number. So, 5 times 1 is 5 plus 2. The answer is 7. Now, we have 5 over 2 and 7 over 5. Pwede na ba natin itong i-add? Hindi pa. Bakit? Kasi dissimilar fraction pa sila. So, we have to convert it to similar fractions by finding the LCD and through listing method. So, the multiples of 2 is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. The multiples of 5 is 5, 10, 15, 20. So, the common multiple, the least common multiple of the 2 is 10. So, we're going to use 10 as the denominator or the least common denominator. Now, 10 divided by 2 is 5 times 5 is 25. Same goes with the other, 10 divided by 5 is 2 times 7 is 14. Now, we already have similar fractions. So, pwede na tayong mag-add ng fractions. We can add it by copying the denominator and then add the numerator. So, 25 plus 14 over 10, which is 39 over 10. Tanong, final answer na ba? Correct, hindi pa. We're still going to convert it to a mixed number. Bakit? Kasi improper fraction siya. So, magiging 39 divided by 10 or the numerator divided by the denominator. So, ilang bang 10 mayroon sa 39? Meron tayong tatlong 10. 3 times 10 is 30, and then mag-subtract tayo. 39 minus 30 is 9. Now, again, yung quotient o yung sagot sa taas, yung 3, yun ang whole number natin. Yung remainder, which is yung 9, ay ang magiging numerator, and then yung divisor ay magiging denominator. So, we have here 3 and 9 over 10. This is the final answer. How about if we're going to multiply fraction? Well, to multiply fraction, we just simply multiply the numerators and the denominators. That is, if we have A over B times C over D, the answer is A times C all over B times D. Para mas maintindihan natin, meron tayong example dito. We have 2 over 3 times 4 over 5. Where yung A natin ay 2, yung B ay 3, yung C ay 4, at yung D natin ay 5. So, meron tayong 2 times 4 all over 3 times 5. The answer is 8 over 15. That, since hindi na siya divisible by anything, that is the final answer. Another example, we have 1 half times 4 over 7. So, 1 times 4 all over 2 times 7. So, 1 times 4 is 4 and 2 times 7 is 14. Now, 4 over 14, is it final or not? Hindi pa. Kasi, if we're going to operate fractions, dapat always natin i-consider na yung answer ay nasa lowest term. Yung 4 over 14 ay hindi pa lowest term kasi both sila, numerator at denominator, ay divisible pa ng 2. So, divide natin ng 2. 4 divided by 2 and 14 divided by 2. The answer is 2 over 7. Final answer? Yes, final answer. Note, if a number in the numerator or denominator is divisible by the same number, then you can cross-multiply. San ba yung numbers na yan? Ito, yung 2 at 4. Denominator ng first fraction at numerator ng second fraction. So, ano ba yung common numbers nila or common na divisible sila pareho? So, we're going to list the factors. The factors of 2 ay 4, 1, and 2. And the factors ng 2 ay 1 and 2. Same sila, mayroong 2. Therefore, both sila divisible ng number na yan. So, 2 divided by 2 is 1, and 4 divided by 2 is 2. So, meron na tayong 1 times 2, and sa denominator ay 1 times 7. Now, 1 times 2 is 2, and 1 times 7 is 7. Notice na hindi na natin need pa mag-simplify or mag-lowest term kasi yung sagot natin naka-lowest term na. Bakit nangyari? Kasi nagkaroon tayo ng cross-multiplication. Notice na pareho lang yung sagot, 2 over 7 and 2 over 7. Now, let's try to multiply mixed fractions. We have here 1 and 1 over 11 times 2 and 3 over 26. Now, in order to multiply mixed numbers, first that we're going to do is to convert these mixed numbers to improper fractions. We have here 1 and 1 over 11. We're just going to copy the denominator, which is 11. And then, i-multiply natin. In order to have the numerator, multiply yung denominator sa whole number. So, 11 times 1 is 11, plus 1 is 12. Yung 2 and 3 over 26 naman, copy yung denominator. And then, 26 times 2. 26 times 2 is 52, plus 3 is 55. Notice na malalaki yung mga numbers natin. 12 over 11 and 55 over 26. Probably, yung magiging sagot natin, hindi siya nasa lowest term. So, let's find the GCF or the factors, the greatest common factors ng mga numerong ito. So, for 11, we have factors na 1 at 11. Sa 55 naman, meron tayong factors na 1, 5, 11, and 55. So, meron silang common, di ba? 11 ang kanilang GCF. So, later, magagamit yan. So, ito naman, so 12. Meron tayong factors na 1, 2, 6, and 12. At yung 26, ay merong factors na 1, 2, 13, and 26. May common ba sa kanila? Meron. Their common factors is 2. So, we're going to divide the numbers with its common factors. So, meron tayo ditong 55 divided by 11, the answer is 5. And then, yung 11, i-divide natin by 11, the answer is 1. Yung 26 naman, at saka yung 12. So, meron tayo ditong 26 divided by 2, since 2 yung GCF nila, is 13, and 12 divided by 2 is 6. Now, we are left with 6 times 5 all over 1 times 13. So, the answer is 30 over 13. Hindi na siya malaki, pero improper fraction naman siya. Bakit? Kasi nag-multiply tayo ng mga mixed number. Therefore, yung sagot natin expected na mixed number din or mixed fraction. So, we're going to convert this improper fraction to a mixed number or mixed fraction. So, meron tayo ditong 30 divided by 13. Ilang bang 13 mayroon ang 30? Dalawa lang. So, 2 times 13 is 26. And then, subtract natin. 30 minus 26 is equal to 4. So, meron tayo ditong yung 4 na remainder ay magiging numerator. Yung 2 na sagot or quotient ay magiging whole number. At 13 ay magiging denominator. So, yung final answer natin dito ay 2 and 4 over 13. Mixed number na siya or mixed form, mixed fraction. Same lang silang tatlo. Mixed number, mixed form, or mixed fraction. So, ito na yung ating sagot dyan. Now, let's proceed sa division ng fraction. The basic rule of dividing fractions is to keep, change, and flip. It means that we have to keep the first fraction as it is, change the division sign to the multiplication sign, and flip the second fraction so that you get the reciprocal. After that, proceed with the steps in multiplying fractions. So, for example, we have here 1/4 divided by 1/2. Ano yung steps natin? Keep, change, and flip. So, we're going to keep the fraction, the first natin na fraction, and then change the operation from division magiging multiplication, and then flip from 1/2, from 1 over 2, naging 2 over 1 siya. Okay? Next is, since yung 2 at 4 natin ay merong common factors na 2, divide natin yan. So, 2 divided by 2 is 1, and 4 divided by 2 is 2. So, ang sagot natin ay 1 times 1 all over 2 times 1, which is 1/2. So, yung sagot natin dyan ay 1/2. Another example, we have here 8 over 9 divided by 4 over 15. Ano nga yung step? Keep, change, and flip. So, keep natin yung first na fraction. I-change natin yung operation from division magiging multiplication, and then flip yung second fraction. So, meron tayong 4 over 15 naging 15 over 4. And then, we're going to proceed na sa steps ng multiplying fractions. Since meron silang mga common factors, we can do cross multiplication or cross cancellation. Parehas lang yan. So, yung common factors ng 8 at 4 ay 4. So, meron tayong 4 divided by 4 is 1 at 8 divided by 4 is 2. Ang 15 naman at saka 9 ay merong common factors na 3. So, 9 divided by 3, or 15 divided by 3 is 5, and 9 divided by 3 is 3. So, we are left with 2 times 5 all over 3 times 1. Ang sagot natin ay 10 over 3. Final answer, hindi. Bakit? Improper fraction. So, we're going to convert it to a mixed form. That is 3 and 1 over 3. So, to do it mentally, meron tayong, ilang bang 3 ang mayroon sa 10? Meron tayong tatlong 3, that is 9. And ilan naman yung remainder? If we have 10 minus 9, it is 1. That's why we have 3 and 1/3. That is the answer. If the fraction are in mixed fraction form, we have to convert it first to improper fraction. So, same lang din. Basta mayroon tayong mga mixed number or mixed fraction, kailangan muna natin itong i-convert to improper fractions. For example, we have here 3 and 3 over 5 divided by 1 and 4 over 5. Convert natin. Meron tayong 18 over 5 divided by 9 over 5. Next is yung keep, change, at flip. So, meron tayo dito, keep natin 18 over 5, i-change natin yung operation, and then i-flip natin yung divisor. So, meron tayo dito, 9 over 5 naging 5 over 9. Since meron mga common factors, yung 9 at saka 18 ay both divisible by 9, 9 divided by 9 is 1, at 18 divided by 2 is, 18 divided by 9 is 2. So, meron tayo ditong 5. Ang dalawang 5, meaning divisible siya ng same number. So, 5 divided by 5 is 1, and 5 divided by 5 is 1. So, meron lang tayong 2 times 1 all over 1 times 1. So, the answer is 2 over 1 or 2. Naintindihan? Now, let's proceed to decimals. A decimal number usually means there is a decimal point in the number. Again, mayroong decimal point. Ang decimal point ang pinaka-importante. It is exactly to the right of the unit's position and tells us what each position means. So, example, decimal ay 1.05, 0.0012, 305.25, 1,000.004. So, how do we add decimals? For example, we have here 305.25 plus 1.05. To add decimals, just follow these few steps. Step 1. Write down the numbers and one and under the other with the decimal. So, kailangan naka-arrange siya. Okay? Naka-align. Importante din yung decimal ay naka-align. So, we have here 305.25 plus 1.05. Next step is add zeros so that hindi tayo malilito. Add zeros so the numbers have the same length. Yung mga bakante kanina, linagyan natin ng mga zeros. Step 3, add normally, remembering to put the decimal to point in the answer. So, mag-add lang tayo. 5 plus 5 is 10. Carry 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. 5 plus 6 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. And 3 plus 0 is 0. And then, bring down lang natin yung decimal point. Now, that is the answer. 306.30. How about if we're going to subtract decimals? Same lang sa ginawa natin sa addition. To subtract decimal, follow lang din ang steps na to. Step 1, write down the numbers one under the other with the decimal. Again, kailangan naka-align. Yung decimal mismo yung naka-align and then yung mga numbers to follow na. Okay? And then, add zeros so that numbers have the same length. Then subtract normally, remembering to put the decimal point in the answer. So, mag-subtract na tayo. 5 minus 0 is 5. 2 minus 5 cannot be, di ba? So, we're going to borrow elementary lessons natin. So, yung 12, yung 2 ay magiging 12. Yung katabi ng 0 magiging 9. At yung katabi ng 0 magiging 9. At saka yung 1 ay magiging 0. Now, pwede na tayo mag-subtract. 12 minus 5 is 7. 9 minus 5 is 4. And 9 minus 2 is 7. And yung 0 ay 0 na yun. So, bring down natin yung decimal place, decimal point. The answer is 74.75. It's very important to align yung decimal place natin. Kasi sa yung nangyayari ay i-bring down lang natin para hindi tayo malilito. So, the answer is 74.75. Now, how about if we're going to multiply decimals? To multiply decimals, we just follow these steps. Again, meron din tayong steps para dyan. First step natin ay multiply normally, ignoring the decimal points. Kung kanina, sa addition and subtraction, ay kailangan naka-align yung decimal point dito sa multiplication kahit hindi na. So, let's start multiplying. 3 times 0 is 0. 3 times 5 is 15, carry 1. 3 times 5 is 15 plus 1 is 16. 3 times 4 is 12 plus 1 is 13. So, sa 0 naman tayo. 0 times 0 is 0. 0 times 5 is 0. 0 times 5 is 0. And 0 times 4 is 0. So, sa 2 naman tayo. 2 times 0 is 0. And 2 times 5 is 10, carry 1. 2 times 5 is 10 plus 1. Yun ang carry. That is 11. And 2 times 4 is 8 plus 1 is 9. Then, we're going to add. Bring down yung 5, and then 5 plus 0 is just 5. 6, bring down then. 3, bring down. 1 plus 1, that is 2, and bring down yung 9. Yung second step naman natin ay yung pag-put lang ng decimal point. So, it will have as many decimal places as the two original numbers combined. So, we're going to count kung ilang decimal place ba meron ng ating dalawang numbers na minultiply. So, we have here 1, 2, 3, 4. So, meron tayong 4 decimal places. So, we're just going to count from right to left ng 4 decimal place. So, yung 0 ay yung first, 5 yung second, 6 yung third, at saka yung 3, yung fourth. Bale, yung decimal place ay yung pupunta in between, after that, 3, okay? In between 2 and 3. So, the answer is 92.3650. Let's have another example. So, we have here 30.25 times 3.5. So, kahit hindi naka-align yung decimal point, it's fine. We're just going to multiply normally. So, 5 times 5 is 25, carry 2. 5 times 2 is 10, plus 2 is 12, carry 1. 5 times 0 is 0, plus 1 is 1. And 5 times 3 is 15. Sa 3 naman tayo. 3 times 5 is 15, carry 1. 3 times 2 is 6, plus 1 is 7, and 3 times 0 is 0, and 3 times 3 is 9. And then, i-add natin, meron tayong 5, and 2 plus 5 is 7, 1 plus 7 is 8, 5 plus 0 is 5, and 1 plus 9 is 10. Count natin kung ilang decimal place. Meron tayong 1, 2, and 3. Meron tayong 3 decimal place. Therefore, we're going to put the decimal point after what number? Correct. After 8. So, magka-count tayo from right to left ng 3 decimal places. 1, 2, 3. So, after dyan, dapat i-put natin yung decimal place. That. So, the answer is 105.875. Let's try dividing decimals. How do we divide decimal? For example, we have here, calculate D is equal to 0.0048 all over 1.0.15. So, the first thing that we're going to do is to convert this into a form na yung denominator niya ay whole number. How do we do it? Yung denominator ay 0.15. Yung decimal places niya ay nasa 100th place. So, we're going to multiply it by 100. So, meron tayong 0.0048 over 0.15 times 100 sila pareho. Para yung denominator natin ay maging whole number. So, meron tayong 0.48 at 15. Ayan, 0.48 and 15. Next, that we're going to do is to divide this just like a normal number. So, meron tayong 0.48 divided by 15. So, the 0 divided by 15 is 0. 4 divided by 15 is 0. But 48, ilang bang 15 mayroon sa 48? That is 3. So, 3 times 15 is 45. Subtract natin, meron tayong 3. Now, dapat walang maging numerator. So, ma-add lang tayo ng 0. So, bring down yung 0 dito. So, ilang 15 mayroon ang 30? Dalawa. So, 2 times 15 is 30. The answer is 0. The remainder is 0. Therefore, our answer, we're going to put the decimal place kung saan nakalagay yung decimal place sa ating dividend. In this case, 0.480 ay naging 0.032. So, yung sagot natin ay 0.032. Another example, we have here, D is equal to 0.026 all over 0.2. Now, kung kanina nag-multiply tayo ng 100, makikita natin dito, yung denominator natin ay nasa 10th place lang, 0.2. So, we're going to convert it by multiplying 10. Kasi 0.2 nasa 10th place lang, hindi 100th place. So, meron tayong 0.026 over 0.2 times 10. Okay? So, yung ating fraction ay naging 0.26. From 0.026 naging 0.26 na lang, all over 2. Again, kailangan kasi yung denominator natin ay whole number. Divide natin. Meron tayo ditong 0.26 divided by 2. So, 0 divided by 2 is 0. 2 divided by 2 is 1. And 1 times 2 is 2, subtract natin, yung sagot ay 0. Bring down natin yung 6. So, meron tayong 6. Ilang 2 ba mayroong ang 6? 3. So, 2 times 2 is 6. Subtract natin, the remainder is 0. So, yung sagot natin dito ay 0.13. Yung decimal place, itataas lang natin. Same spot, okay? Same place value. That is 0.13. So, yung sagot natin dito ay 0.13. Now, let's convert decimals to fraction. For example, we have here 2.34. Let's convert this to fraction. Yung 2 dyan, sa left after decimal point ay yung whole units. At saka yung numbers to the right ng decimal point ay yung fractional part. So in this case, there are 2 decimal places. So we put 100 into the denominator. Bakit? Kasi yung decimal places natin to the right ng ating decimal place ay 2. That is 100th place. So we put 100 sa denominator. So 2 yung whole number, 34 yung numerator, again fractional part 'yan. So siya yung numerator, and then the denominator is 100. Since we have here 2 decimal place. And next thing to do is to reduce it to lowest term. So how to reduce it? Divide natin yung numerator and denominator by their common factors, which is 2. So 34 divided by, copy natin yung 2, yung whole number. 34 divided by 2 is 17. Yung denominator naman, 100 divided by 2 is 50. So the answer is 2 and 17 over 15. Another example, we have here 1.5. So 1 yung whole unit natin at saka 5 yung nasa fractional part. In this case, there is only 1 decimal place, di ba? Yung number after ng decimal to the right ay 1 lang, one number lang, which is 5. That's why we put 10. Bakit? It is on its 10th decimal place. So yung denominator ay 10. Yung fractional, yung whole units ay yung magiging whole number natin sa fraction. At yung 5 ay yung magiging numerator. Final answer, hindi. We need to convert this to, or reduce this to lowest term. How do we do that? We're going to divide the numerator and denominator by the common factor, or the GCF, which is 5. So 5 divided by 5, copy natin yung 1. 5 divided by 5 is 1, and 10 divided by 5 is 2. So our answer here is 1 and 1 half. Therefore, 1.5, pag convert natin sa fraction, ay 1 and 1 half. Now, converting fractions to percent. In converting fractions to percent, we just follow these simple steps. So, if we have A over B, magiging A divided by B times 100. And the answer will be the converted fraction, or that will become a percent. For example, convert 22 over 25 to percent. So yung A natin ay 22, yung B natin ay 25. So magiging 22 divided by 25 times 100 is equal C. Now, what is 22 divided by 25? That is 0.88. I-times natin sa 100%, or we're going to move the decimal point to the right. Makailang beses? Makadalawa, kasi nag-multiply tayo ng 100. So, that will become 88%. Therefore, 22 over 25 is equal to 88%. Another example, convert 3 over 4 to percent. So we have here 3 divided by 4. Times 100 is equal to C percent. 3 divided by 4 is 0.75. Times 100, again, move lang yung decimal place to the right makadalawang beses. That will be 75%. Therefore, 3 over 4 is equal to 75%. That ends our discussion on fractions, decimals, and percent. I hope you learned something. Goodbye!